Welcome to Floorball Future Stars tournament played in Helsinki. Helsinki, it's not Helsinki, it's Eerikkilä in Finland. I apologize for that. Fourth match of the day is about to begin. We've had three matches so far, two from the women's side and one from the men's side. Men's side, Germany, men under 19, they lost to Finland today earlier 7-4. Finland's team, the one named with Tiitu, took a win on that game, and now Germany's under 19 team is about to take up Switzerland's men under 17. We have one more match today coming up later on. That will be women's match between Finland and Germany. But now for the lineups for the upcoming match. Let's start with the away team, Switzerland. Starting lineup from forwards: Nino Bühler, Sebastian Mathis, Dominik Hofer, and defenders Timo Sutter and Yannick Hirschi. Second line: Andrin Christen, center Robin Thalman, right wing Marvin Langhart, and defenders Noah Muhlbach and Robin Ruek. Third line from the left: Loris Gislik, center Jonan Meyer, right forward Robin Lohr. Defenders Niels Engeler and Timon Anderek. Fourth line forward: Jamie Ashleman, center Nies Buhmann, and right forward Severin Schmidt. Defenders Janis Ulrich and Jan Fleisch. Starting goalkeeper from Team Switzerland, Ilya Brunner. Second goalkeeper, Janis Rost. Before we go to the home team, Germany, let's greet the teams and listen to the national anthems.
Thank you. Finland Open Germany.
Both the teams excited to start. Before we start, let's have Germany's lineup, starting lineup. Forward, Georg Martin Ganz, center Lasse Könnecke, right forward Dominic Deschau, defenders Frido Bolz and Niklas Gunas. Second line, forward Adrian Stein, center Daniel Wiffler, right forward Valentin Müller, defenders Lovis Sturm and Niklas Blanke. Third line, forwards Marvin Eilers, Luca Winter and Luis Rüger, defenders Lasse Bopp and Jonas Balzer. Fourth line, one forward there, Jakob Heinz, and defenders Julius Ondruska and Jesaja Hummel. Starting goalkeeper Erik Schnecke and the second goalkeeper Milan Urumovic. As mentioned, Germany has already played one game today. They lost 7-4 to Finland. And it was a really exciting game having Germany in the lead after the first period by 1-2. However, Finland was able to score the six next goals, making it 2-7-2 before Germany then was able to convert into two more goals in the three last minutes of the game. Interesting to see, especially actually Germany's best scorer in that game, Jakob Heinz, with two goals. He's starting in the fourth line, so basically not starting the game. Other scorers from that game, Daniel Wiffler and Luis Rüger. Wiffler on the center on the second line and Rüger on the third line right forward. Quick recap on the starting lineups. Switzerland, Buller, Mathis, Hofer, Sutter, Hirschi and Brunner in goals. Germany, Ganz, Könnecke, Deschau, Bolz, Kunas and Schnecke. And Germany, the team is under 19 years old. There are four players that have played in the U19 WFCs last year. For Switzerland, the team is under 17. An interesting matchup. Mathis and Könnecke in the first face-off. Switzerland with the ball. infraction in the corner. Quick free hit. Germany not giving much pressure. Mathis giving it back to Hirschi. Hirschi and Sutter having a patient opening of the game, looking for openings in Germany's defense. Lasse Koenig, the team captain, now with the ball. Hirschi back to Koenig. Switzerland really wanted to take control of the ball in the beginning of the game, having a really, should I say, relaxed first shift for the first minute, an opportunity to go, but there's substitution in progress, both teams with the second line. Christen, and the first shot taken by Robin Thalman goes wide and over. Lovi Sturm gives the ball to Daniel Wiffler, and the first opening for Team Germany. Stein finds Müller. Sturm getting pressure. Müller back to Sturm. Stein. Excellent move and pass. First shot for Germany goes wide. Next opportunity. That is snatched by Ilya Brunner. Patiently played by Germany. A good attempt. Let's see how Switzerland responds. Nils Engeler. Passes to Robin Lohr. Lohr moves into the center, but gives it back to Jona Meyer. Very careful beginning for the game. Now a quick long pass. Excellent defending there from Germany. Lasse Bob there intercepting that Swiss try. Germany now getting possession of the ball, making sure it stays that way. Gunath, nice spin in the center, gives it back to fellow defender Frido Bols. Gunath finds Gans there in the middle of the offensive zone. Swiss defense is close by, and Gans is not able to convert from that. Four minutes and 15 seconds gone from the first period. Swiss attempt, good pass to the center, however lost it. There's Nino Buhler, of course, trying for the shot. Blanke good passing. And a wide shot. Excellent passes, and that really could have been the opening goal. Infraction. No, it's a referee ball. Bodulovi-Sturm, Germany backing to their own end of court. Excellent interception, 2-1. Good guiding from the defense, movement towards the corner, not creating a scoring opportunity. Let's see the next part. A free ball there, right in front of the goal. However, team captain Niklas Blanke is the one who cleans up the front of the goal. Germany in possession of the ball. Substituting the next line. Everyone on the court from the third line. Lasse Bopp. Jonas Balzer opening up the game. Luca Winter helping up, being doubled. However, it's a German hit in. Bopp to Balzer. Winter. Either of the teams are not taking any risks in opening. Germany 3-on-2. Pause that never comes. A bit of pressure there by the German forwards. Now there's an opening for Switzerland. And it's the first goal of the game. 6 minutes and 34 seconds. Germany giving high pressure, opens up the defense formation, and Switzerland takes advantage of it. Goal scoring by Loris Kislik. 6 minutes, 34 seconds on the clock. To find a way to open. Kunas Koneke to the left side. Guns was there in front of the Swiss goal, but no pass could be made to him. Kunas now trying to get first to the ball, but there's Swiss defender Yannick Hirschi first on the ball. Hirschi giving the ball to Sebastian Mathis. And the play continues with the German hit in after some dispute. Captain puts the ball into play, and what a great goal. Excellent pass and excellent shot from Valentin Müller. Niklas Blanke with the assist. Wide pass. And Ilya Brunner has a wide movement to make, which he does not quite do. And the first call for Team Germany has taken place. Kishlik. Engeler left to Meyer, back to Engeler. Long pass in the corner. Anderek gets pushed over the boards. Lasse Bob there with the infraction. Switzerland substitutes and the ball is not in play, so this is all right. They have time to discuss what to do with the free hit in the offensive end. Mathis and Hofer making the plans there, a shot blocked. And now a hit in from the other corner. Hofer to Buhler. Niklas Kunath is the one coming out with the ball, 2-1. A counter-attack there after Dominic Deschau's shot on the other end. Quick exchange of attacks. No results for either of the teams. Niklas Blanke and Lovie Sturm opening Germany's game. A bit of bad passing there, not to be too concerned of. Slows down the opening a bit. Blanke finds Müller with a cross pass, a bit similarly as to their first goal. Let's see how Switzerland responds. Excellent defending by Daniel Wiffler. Luca Winter and Jonas Balzer with Lasse Bob here on the right side, getting crowded when Rüger tries to enter the center. Finally, an infraction from Rüger himself. Patience continues. With the opening, both teams have done good job in forechecking as well. Not easy to find room in the defensive formation. Langhart to Mühlebach. Mühlebach checking the movement to the center. Mühlebach trying to get a shot. Ball slips away. Still in Switzerland's possession. Ruek gives the ball back to Langhart. Marvin Langhart gets pressured. Luis Rüger there with giving the high pressure. Stealing the ball, 2-1. And it's a goal for Germany. excellently played with the pressure. Louis Ruger does the, should I say, hard work for the goal. Gives a pass. And Marvin Eilers has a rather easy job there in taking Germany to 2-1 lead. 11:36 on the clock. Switzerland wins the face-off. Germany giving pressure. Now a counter, a cross pass. Robin Lord does not quite get the opportunity to shoot there, but a very good advantage taken from the Swiss team, opening that pressure. And the pressure now in deep Germany's end. Fantastic save. And now a counter to the other end. A quick shot there from the right. Now there's a bit of flow from both teams in attacking. That is until Yannick Hirschi takes control of the ball, sees that everyone else has substituted, and it's now the first lines against. Germany, actually it's the Germany's second line there. Lovis Sturm trying to get past the pressure. Switzerland taking control of the ball again. Mathis. Germany giving now high pressure, and well indeed. Hirschi, Mathis, good pass. Dominik Hofer not able to continue from the assist. That was a close shot from Nino Buller. Germany has definitely amped up the pressure now. No more looking at calm Swiss opening. Until they now drop a bit, not seeing the possibility to pressure anymore. Christian giving the ball to Müllerbach. Thalmann just getting the ball, coming in the center. Well shot and well saved by Erik Schnecke. Niklas Kunas with the ball. Könnecke to the corner. Swiss interception. Ball all the way to Schnecke. And back to Kunas. Pass to the center. Gons gives it back to defenders. Not seeing a possibility to continue forward. Gons now on the right, trying to get past Swiss defense. Not much more luck in the Swiss counterattack. Kunath balls. Swiss pressure there. well saved that shot by Robin Thalman there. Now high stick on the center. Blanke, difficult shot, being deflected a bit on the way. Engeler, a pass to the center goes to Lovi Sturm. Sturm is being pressured by Robin Lohr. However, Sturm is able to keep the ball in Germany's possession. Wiffler, Blanke, trying to find a cross opening, not finding one. Blanke again. Stein giving it back to Sturm. Wiffler. Switzerland also looking for an opportunity to change, therefore not giving pressure. Winter to Bob. Balzer. Quick passes with Eilers. Eilers moving, passing to Balzer, but a bit of miscommunication there. Not correctly timed. And then Switzerland smells an opportunity to give pressure. 17-19 has been played from the first period. 2-on-2. And now a Swiss counter. However, there's German defenders to block that attack attempt. A German foul. And the Swiss captain Nino Buhler putting the ball into play. Sutter. Hirschi to Buhler. Buhler. And the other Swiss openers taking their time again. Germany not seeing possibility to give pressure. They're taking it rather low in the formation right now. Most likely wanting to be in control of the end of the period. A good steal from Luis Ruger. Lasse Bopp leaving the ball to Niklas Kunas. Koenecke to Deschamps. Gets crowded in the corner. Sutter. Thalman. Getting now a bit pressured. Rueck. Solomon getting, coming back down to help with the opening. Being high up for a while there. Challenge on the center. No shot. Last 30 seconds. And it's Switzerland's ball currently. They're taking their time. Both teams substituting. And the last 10 seconds are about to start with Swiss possession. Long ball. Intercepted by Blanke. And the first period has ended with Germany on the lead. They scored twice. in the first period, the first goal of the game scored by Team Switzerland. So it's 2-1. I'll be back in about 7 minutes when we are ready with the highlights and ready for the second period. Welcome back to Eerikkilä, where we have Germany U19 playing against Switzerland U17. First period has been played. Germany in 2-1 lead. Loris Gislik was the scorer of the first goal, assisted by Robin Lohr. It was less than a minute from that when Germany responded. An offensive free hit, Niklas Blanke, a cross pass to Valentin Müller, and his one-timer shot to equalize the game. 4 minutes after that, Marvin Eilers was able to take Germany to 2-1 lead, assisted by Luis Rüger. Very controlled game from the first period. Both teams taking very little risks in opening, a few times, especially Germany giving pressure when opportunity for that was seen. That also opened the opportunity for Switzerland for counter attacks. That is also how the first Swiss goal took place. Let's see how the second period starts. Lasse Könnecke stronger there in the face-off. Kunath. And there is number 29, Jago Pines. I think number 22, yes, Dominic Deschau has been now substituted from the first line of Germany. Jago Pines scored 2 goals in the first game of the day that they had. Switzerland with the scoring opportunity there, not able to convert. Both teams substituting and second line matchup. This cross pass is something we've seen before. Good try by Müller there. Germany still giving a bit of pressure. However, there's an infraction. A hit in the stick. And Switzerland. Robin Thalmann and Robin Rueg are opening the red team's offense. Mühlebach. A bit of pressure there. Müller. Switzerland coming past. Blanke directing the offense to the corner. Thalmann returning the ball to Mühlebach there, and then a bit of bouncing on the midcourt. Thalmann, Rueg, shot from the right, blocked right away. Maybe even slipped a bit. Mühlebach there. Strong defending from Switzerland. Daniel Wiffler is able to keep the ball in Germany's control, however. Balzer to Bock. Winter. A Not much room in the center. Ball still with Germany. A bit of opportunity for Switzerland to give pressure. However, there was only one attacker doing that. Lor. And that is for Switzerland's advantage. They have a free hit. That pass is distracted by Marvin Eilers. Eilers, the player who's currently, who's done the leading goal in the game. After excellent back-checking work from Luis Ruger. Great save from Erik Schnecke. There, Switzerland really having an opportunity to equalize. Winter. Bob. And a shot. Well over the goal. A running competition to the ball. Swiss free hit. Sebastian Masic puts the ball into play. Janek Hirschi gives it to Timo Sutter. Good defense now from Frido. Balls there, able to prevent the pass to Dominik Hofer. Next attempt, Masic. Sutter. Hirschi. Active pressure now. Heinz is able to get the ball, but the play goes into the corner. Germany gets a free hit. Müller and Stein with the ball. The Swiss team steals it. Stein is there blocking movement from Robin Dahlmann and therefore a whistle. Solid defensive work from Germany. Now time for a bit of pressure. A good attempt from Switzerland, however, Müller gets into a counter-attack shot opportunity. A save from Ilya Brunner. Rueck. Finally, Germany drops the pressure, and Switzerland is able to change with the ball. Nils Engeler. Timon Anderek now opening. A good cross pass. Then comes Lasse Bopp to steal the ball. Good defending from Switzerland on that counter-attack. Bob getting the ball, trying to pass it to Eilers. A bit of miscommunication there. The pass going a bit further and Eilers not being able to gain possession. Anderek. Engeler. 7 minutes of the second period have passed. No goals yet seen in this period. Shot from the side, deflected. And Switzerland continues with a hit in from the corner. Let's see now what kind of magic are they offering. Mathis and Hofer with the ball. It's merely a pass to the defender, Janik Hirschi. That kind of dries up right away. An opportunity to attack deep in the offensive zone, and now Switzerland is opening. This gives a bit room though. Hirschi, and a shot. Perfectly thought shot. First he looked at a possibility to pass, however then he realizes that this is actually an excellent opportunity to shoot behind the block of Frido Bols, a precise shot. So after that offensive free hit, Switzerland went all the way back into their own defensive zone. Germany gave pressure on the opening, and that is how it then created space for the counter-attack and the equalizer. Assist there by Sebastian Mathis, and that's a huge save from Ilya Brunner. Germany was looking for a quick scoring for the lead again. But Ilya Brunner thought differently about that. Blanke to Müllerbach. Sorry, Lovis Sturm, obviously. Müllerbach being the number six in the other team. Andrin Christen putting the ball into play. Rueck to Müllerbach. Engeler. Müller is now pressuring as he's looking for a change himself. A bit crowded there in front of the goal. Germany with an attempt and an excellent goal to take Germany to 3-2 lead. Luis Rüger with Marvin Eilers with the assist. Really well played by Germany. An effective attack. And solid scoring in front of the goal. A bit of hassle there in the middle. Hirschi. Bühler to find Mathis. Mathis back to Nino Buller, Janik Hirschi, who scored the second goal for Switzerland. Heinz tries to pass to the center. Frido Balls was there, but kept well. Hirschi with an infraction in the corner. Does not look pleased. Both teams substitute, and Andrea Stein making the pass. Robin Thalman now there with the ball. Gets pressured. However, that is not abiding the rules. Germany drops the formation a bit. And here we go again with the opening from Team Switzerland. A counter well defended from Christian. Counter now from Switzerland. Again, important defensive work this time. Love Sturm blocking that pass. Langhart gives it to Müllerbach. And now it's Robin Rueck's effort in the opening. Müllerbach coming to help. Lineups substituting, and Niels Engeler. Anderet getting pressured. And this has been the most efficient line from Germany. Eilers and Rüge both with one goal and one assist. Now Switzerland's counter. High pass attempt across the German defense, gets intercepted. Bob leaves the ball for Kunas. Heinz gets blocked for the second time as well. Engeler having pressure from Heinz. A bit of pressure there on the side. Switzerland still on the ball. Heinz shot and well saved by Ilya Brunner. Minutes and 29 seconds has passed from the second period, so we're over halfway through. Germany in 3-2 lead. Scoring wise, this has been Germany's so far, though Switzerland obviously having made two goals also has been very efficient in those places where the opportunity has opened. Hirschi Mathes looking to substitute, giving back to Hirschi. Obviously, Hirschi's looking to get into the bench himself. Müllerbach short from the sides, goes overboard. Well, high and over, and German hit in. It's number 14 now with the ball, Jesaja Hummel. Hummel started on the bench. Sanchez, as did Jago Pines. And there's the duo of Rüger and Eilers. However, there's a foul in the corner causing all that trouble. Lord to Meyer. Meyer gets doubled now. It's a 3-on-2. That's a short 3-on-2 now to the other end. I was about to say that he should have shot himself instead of that pass that got then blocked, but he used that opportunity well to see that Erik Schnecke was off balance. Maybe this was the best way to get the goalkeeper out of the way. Trying to make that pass, Schnecke was well moving with that pass that came to Loris Kislik. That was now the second goal for Loris Kislik in this game. Brunner with the save. Mathis. Hirschi. Hirschi going past. Hofer looking for an opportunity to pass, not finding a good one. Brunner not quite getting that ball. This one was a lot easier for him. Hirschi, Müllerbach, shot deflected to the corner. Blanke there giving pressure. Shot, but there are too many players in front of that one. Robin Rueck there with the shot. There's the Team Germany now with the ball. 19, Julius Ondruska. Also started in the fourth line, so Germany has, well, with the exception of the second goalkeeper, has been playing all men from the lineup. Müller with the long pass. Wiffler with the shot. That's deflected, and Germany gets to continue in the offensive end. 17:32 has passed. So a bit less than 2 and half minutes left of the second period. Balzer now with the ball in the defensive end. Eilers comes as well as Winter come to help with the opening. Yes, Aya Hummel with the shot there, going wide, continuing with the pressure. Not much luck there. Ball going off the rink. Engeler. Anderek. Lor. To Anderek, who was there very high at the other end, however. Switzerland needs to return the ball back to their own end of the court. Now it's a matchup of the first lines to start the last minute of the period. Hirschi. Hofer. And there's Bühler with the rebound just in time. Schnecke there with a save. Kunas intercepted. Balls blocks the shot following that interception. Nino Bühler. Riffler blocked. And a steal. And a counter from Switzerland. Let's see how this plays. Now, well, a counter by Germany. Müller pass to try and find Adrian Stein there. Hirschi not looking happy with his pass. The ball slipped a bit to the side and Germany got a scoring opportunity. Luckily, Lilia Brunner was there strong, as is Erik Schnecke in the other end. 3-3 is the result after two periods. Coming in after the first period, the game was 2-1 for Germany. In the second period, Switzerland scored twice, Germany once. And let's have a look at those goals in the highlights near to the third period. I'll be back in around 7 minutes. Welcome back to Eerikkilä, and the competition between Germany and Switzerland after two periods. It's an exciting tie at three. We saw several scoring opportunities in the second period. Before we go through those, let's check the saves so far. Erik Schnecke, Team Germany, so far 11 saves in the game. Ilya Brunner, Team Switzerland, 12 saves. And yes, going back to the goals, obviously it was a 2-1 lead after the first period for Germany. So yes, we first saw that equalizer by Yannick Hirschi. 2 minutes later, Louis Rüger, assisted by Marvin Eilers, took Germany to the lead again, 3-2. And then about 6 minutes later, Loris Kischlik equalized the game from a counter-attack. Tried to pass right in front of the goal. Pass deflected back to him. Erik Schnecke was out of balance, and Loris Kischlik took advantage of that, tying the game to 3-3. So yes, three goals in the first period, three goals in the second. Let's see how many we see in the third period. Germany giving high pressure with Brunner having the ball, and this is what happens after that 7 seconds. 7 seconds, and Dominik Hofer quick throw by Ilya Brunner, team captain Nino Buhler assisting to Dominik Hofer. And that high pressure by Germany, it blows right away on their face. Interesting third period coming up. 7 seconds it took for the first goal. Müller, Stein giving pressure. Müller with the foul, protesting it. Switzerland quickly already substituted, so currently it's Switzerland's third line against Germany's second. Engele to Anderek. Engele, Lohr. Meyer getting the ball back, trying to find Anderek in front of the goal. Intercepted by Germany. Eilers. Now we see some new players from Team Switzerland as well. Number 15 there, Jamie Oeschlimann with the ball right now. Pass to Hofer. Oeschlimann pressured by Lasse Bopp. Foul there. Corner play. Bopp is almost able to intercept, and now there's the first power play. And it will be for Team Switzerland. From Lasse Bopp, continuous infraction. And from Switzerland on the power play, it will be Jamie Oeschlimann with the ball. There's Noah Mühlebach in the center. Sean and Meyer, they're now with the ball. Captain Nino Buhler. And number 14, Timo Satter. Suter to Oeschlimann. Buhler. Frieda balls there. The short-handed play blocks the assist. On the box play, there's also Lasse Könnecke. Jakob Heinzen, what a shot from the side. Nino Buhler, he doesn't really care who's on the box play. And Lasse Bopp looking devastated, going to the court. Getting cheers from his teammates. But it must not be much of consolence. A great goal from the side. Daniel Wiffler and Severin Schmidt playing his first change of the game, number 7 for Switzerland. And there's the next penalty. What an eventful start for the third period. So far, we've had 3 minutes and 5 seconds of the play in the third period. We've had 2 goals and 2 penalties. Let's see if Germany is able to convert this now that Switzerland has taken a 2-goal lead. Heinz. Kunas. Rüger, Wiffler, and then Müller are the ones who are on the power play, and a precise shot. This time a very low one, but from the side, doesn't take much time, 20 seconds from the power play. Good assists, easy to shoot right away from the assist. And Jakob Heinz just looks as if this is just another day in the office. Germany 4, Switzerland 5. 3 minutes and 25 seconds have been played on the third period. So we've managed to see that 3 goals already in the start of the period. Let's see if we'll see more Lasse Boppi. Yes, Aya Hummel, a good movement. The pass is a bit slow there, but Gans is able to rescue it. Shot blocked. Now Hirschi, Gans in the corner. Mathis back to Hirschi. Bob aggressive there in the pressure. Eilers. Bühler. What a place for Jair Martin Gans to score from there. Not able to equalize from that, but Germany has certainly put on the next gear and are looking to equalize. Kunas. Koenecke. Balls to Heinz. It seems that Dominic Deschau has returned to this line. Heinz replaced him on the second. Quick shot from the side going past to the cross corner. Mühlebach is being fouled. Schmid there in the corner. Germany able to intercept and Frieder balls. And others from his line are looking to change. Welcoming Daniel Wiffler's line to the court. Niklas Blanke. Wiffler. Long assist to the front of the Swiss goal. And it's power play for Switzerland again. It's number 27, Niklas Blanke, for obstructing. 2 minutes penalty. Bühler and Thalmann bringing the ball up to the offensive end. Lohr, Christen and Hofer are the other players now on this power play. A different lineup now. Thalmann, Lohr, Lohr with the shot. Goes a bit wide. 2-on-1 Germany shorthanded. And it's the leg snap from Ilya Brunner that saves Team Switzerland there. A good attempt from Germany to equalize shorthanded. Heinz giving pressure. Mühlebach. This is now the first power play that Switzerland used for scoring. Meyer there giving pressure to Hummel, paying off. Aeschlimann Only Heinz intercepting it for Germans. And this is for the advantage of Team Germany. Hit in from the corner. Possibly a good attempt to score. Müller. Bühler trying to block his way. And this was a very efficient box play by Team Germany. Both teams have had successful power play now in this third period. But for the second power play that Switzerland had, Germany was able to find the way to defend that. And we continue with the score of being 4 for Germany, 5 for Switzerland, 8-40 played from the third period. Eilers. The pass goes right until the end of Germany's own defense zone. And what an opportunity there for number 7, Severin Schmidt. And what a save. There's a bit of discussion on which corner should the play continue. Switzerland uses this for substituting Bühler. Mathis, Hofer, Schliemann and Hirschi. Intercepted by Germany, but Bühler intercepts it back. Mathis, Hofer, an attempt from small angle. Not able to convert, but nevertheless, Switzerland's ball. There's also now number 16, Nils Buhmann. Good effort from Noah Müllerbach. Schmidt shot wide. Müllerbach there trying to squeeze between two players, not able to do that. A counter, well seen. And Schmidt with a shot that's right on the top bar, but not quite in. Really well played, really well passed by Nils Buhmann there. He really saw the second wave there coming, that empty space where he passed, and Schmidt was able to take an excellent shot from there. Really close to the score being 4-6. Schmidt. This time Schmidt trying to find Buhmann. Under it. Demon Underek passing to Niels Engelar. Engelö teasing Jesaja Huma there a bit. Germany giving pressure. 3-2. The ball's able to take the ball for his team, waiting to get Dominik Nechau. Lovi Sturm and others on the court. A bit of mixed lineups now. Balls or maybe not mixed lineups but changes in the lineups. Heinz almost intercepted, not quite. What a shot. Luckily for Team Switzerland, going past and wide. And now it's a timeout for Team Germany. And what a shot was that. Really well assisted. That was all about that assist that created that space and opportunity to score. Severin Schmidt really close in taking his team already to a two-goal lead. Deschau, Heinz, Hummel, Koenig and Balls. This is the lineup with which Germany is looking to equalize. The ball in Switzerland's possession, Yannick Hirschi coming to put the ball into play once the referee gives the permission. There is still something that's been discussed. With the referee, I think there was something to check with the official time of the game. So the referee instructed the officials of the game on how to use the clock so that it will be in the right time. Now the ball is in play. Switzerland's attack counter. Switzerland able to make it tougher from Germany, but now it's intercepted. And what a shot. What a shot to the bar. Really quick shot, basically an open net, with Brunner having to have that wide movement there. Hummel with an interception. Deschau giving it to Boss. Müller not quite getting the possession of the ball. Germany, however, getting him back to them. Julius Ondruska to Niklas Blanke. Biffler also down helping with the opening. Stein. Ondruska. Biffler not able to pass Schmidt. Good movement from the Swiss defense in the forechecking, and finally it pays off. All the patience in defending. A hit in for Switzerland. Anderek. Engler back to Anderek. pressure from Germany. A high pass, Robinlor not quite able to convert that, and the next attempt already right away after. Hummel to the side, quick pass from Deschau to the other side, however there was no one there. 2-1. And that pass is blocked by the defending team. Switzerland still with one goal lead. Hirsche being doubled right away, loses the ball. Shot quite far away. Easy save by Ilya Brunnar. Blanke. Ondruska. Back to Blanke. Wiffler not having room there in the center. No room still. Schliemann losing the stick for a while there. Still able to regain the forechecking possession. Germany not able to find openings in the formation. They would clearly like to use the center and are not settling for the sides. This time it opens, but they are not able to get further. That's a hasty counter from Switzerland, and Germany gets the ball. Mathis. Blanke. And an interception. Shot blocked. Very good blocking there by the Swiss team. Müller wrestles the ball to his own team. Jesaja Hummel. Frida balls. Koenig with a long pass, intercepted. A tip attempt from Niels Boomen. Just a bit wide. 3 minutes on the clock. Impressive is that shot by Jakob Heinz. Heinz is one of those players who's played in the U19 World Floorball Championships. He plays in the Pixbo Wallenstam Academy. And he has made many impressive shots during the game. Very efficient as well, though hitting some bars as well. 2 minutes and 15 seconds left. Switzerland with one goal lead. There are no extra times or penalties when the time has run out. That's the final score. Müller trying to pass. Shot hits the post. A good attempt on scoring. Rather small angle though, and Ilya Brunner well there following the shot. Bühler, and a goal after all of the pressure from the German team. Switzerland is able to make the next goal. And it's Jan Fleisch. This is either his first time on the court, or then I have missed him in the earlier changes that he might have had. But Jan Fleisch there in front of the goal. Nino Buller as the assister. Infraction there. Heinz wanting to take that shot. Heinz is protesting for the distance. He's saying that the blocking player was less than 3 meters away. Interception, Wiffler. Müller trying to make a shot from the small angle, and it will be power play. And it will be power play for Team Germany as Nils Engeler will be sitting in a 2 minute penalty. So we've seen one power play goal that was scored by Jakob Heinz. One power play goal by Germany. That is, of course, Switzerland scored its own. Heinz most likely will be blocked to no effect. He is still able to make the shot, however, it goes wide. 49 seconds left of the game. Germany needs to be able to make two goals in order to equalize the game. Heinz blocked. Excellent block there by Sutter. Wiffler. Müller, Heinz, and what an assist. I think everyone was waiting for that shot, but instead Heinz passes to Daniel Wiffler. It's a soft, rather slow pass even, but Wiffler is there just waiting to put the ball into the net. 25 seconds left. Switzerland having 1 goal lead. Heinz and Buller in the face-off. Germany giving high pressure. Eschlimann lose the ball. Kirschi gets crowded there. Wiffler. Heinz. And there it is. There it is. Switzerland winning with the shortest possible score. Germany 5, Switzerland 6. And this means that Germany played 2 games today and had 2 tight games with 2 losses. The numbers against Finland Team Tiitu were a bit bigger. The loss was there 4-7. This time is 5-6. And these teams will be playing the next time tomorrow. There will be one more game this evening. It will be a women's game starting in 45 minutes. Finnish U17 will be playing against Germany's U19. And yes, these teams tomorrow, Germany will be playing at 2 p.m. Finnish time. They will be playing against Finland's team Kohonen. And then Switzerland will be playing 6:30 p.m. Finnish time against Finland's team Tiitu. I thank you for watching. I will be back in 35 minutes for the last game of the evening.